From the Tribune News Network, this is News Break. I'm Kirk Smith. Friday's top stories. No turning back, apparently. Despite criticism, the Ministry of Works goes ahead with its plan to tear down what it considers to be illegal structures being built in the farm shanty town in Abaco. About 45 of what the ministry describes as incomplete and unoccupied structures were demolished in an exercise carried out yesterday, and the ministry is defending that decision, releasing a statement saying the government remains firm in its resolve that the health hazards and hazardous conditions that unregulated communities foster are dealt with decisively and effectively. The Human Rights Bahamas Group has released a statement in reaction to that move, saying in part it's unfortunate that the government would choose to create another humanitarian crisis on the island of Abaco. The latest on the coronavirus situation. Tourism Minister De Aguilar happy about that decision to allow fully vaccinated people into the country without having to get a negative test. He is calling it a shot in the arm. Says it would make the country a more attractive destination for visitors. The Nurses Union has some reservations about that, saying there's no guarantee at this point that fully vaccinated persons won't contract or spread the virus. The move is effective the 1st of May. The Prime Minister made that announcement in the House this week. This is News Break from the Tribune News Network. Latest corona numbers now still on the high side, especially in the capital. 58 additional confirmed cases for Tuesday, spread over six islands, 42 in the capital, 11 in Grand Bahama. The hospital numbers still up there, 50 persons being treated, 4 in the ICU. No additional deaths have been reported. Immigration officials have released a statement saying that an investigation into a rape allegation made by a woman detained at the Carmichael Road Detention Center has been completed, and there is, quote, no substance to it. The statement says the woman who made the complaint has denied any inappropriate conduct towards her. Immigration officials say the matter is closed. There'll be no further statement on it. A 19-year-old Grand Bahama man, Hayward Dorset of Holmes Rock, in trouble with the law, accused of having sex with a 13-year-old girl and possession of pornographic video of the minor. Agriculture Ministry officials say complaints of inaction by the government following that recent fire at the Pardeski dock are, quote, misleading. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at tribune242.com. Now the Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of insurance management. That frontal system is still in the area. There's still some related weather around. Some clouds, some sun, chances showers, highs in the low to mid-80s. 80 at Freeport, 83 in the capital, 85 at Matthewtown. No marine advisories, winds generally 10 to 15 knots. The sea is 2 to 4 feet. There's a high tide now, the next low around noon. Turning partly cloudy tonight, maybe a passing shower still in the area. Lows from the low to mid-70s. For complete weather information, check the Tribune's weather page. For your insurance needs, call Insurance Management. They offer a wide range of insurance products. Give them a call today for all of your insurance needs. With more than 40 years in business, nobody does it better than Insurance Management. This is News Break from the Tribune News Network.
Let's get the weekend started. The Weekend, published every Friday in the Tribune, has the hottest news in fashion, music tips, the who's who on the red carpet, your must-try restaurants and hotspots, and of course, what to wear when you step out. Catch up on the latest film reviews or be thrilled with exciting tales from Bahamian history. There's only one place to find everything you need to plan your perfect weekend, in Friday's Tribune. Pick up your copy of The Weekend every Friday. The Tribune, the people's paper, biggest and best.
Friday's World News headlines. India continues to deal with the spread of the coronavirus in that country despite vaccinations around the world. Another day with record numbers, more than 2,000 deaths and more than 300,000 cases. They're running out of hospital space, forcing restrictions in several Indian states to try and control that spread. Japan forced to put restrictions in place in certain parts of the country because of a surge in cases there, including Tokyo, just 3 months before the Olympic Games. Time is running out for 53 crew members on an Indonesian submarine, which is lost at sea in the area of Bali. The ship will run out of oxygen in a matter of hours if it's not found in time. Tribune's gas tracker prices heading into the weekend. Shell 486, Esso 488, Rubis $4.93 per gallon in the capital. Now your sports notes brought to you by the Tribune Sports section. Get the latest on Kai Jones as he prepares to enter the upcoming NBA draft. He could be the next Bahamian NBA player. Get the latest on DeAndre Ayton. He's already there with the Phoenix Suns. 10 points, 9 rebounds for him last night in a Phoenix loss in Boston. Catch up on track star Stephen Gardner. Get his thoughts on the Bahamas missing the World Relays this year. There's a Jazz Chisholm update in the Tribune Sports on the rest of Major League Baseball in the Tribune Sports Friday. For all of your sports details, you want to check the Tribune Sports section. Everything you need from the world of sports you'll find in the Tribune Sports. And that's your news break. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper on the streets first thing in the morning. Stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.